Good morning, everybody. We have studied that safe drinking water or clean drinking water is very essential for good health. Similarly, one of the important thing which is necessary for good health is sanitation. Now, the sanitation is also one of the public facility which the government should provide. Now, sanitation is necessary for prevention of waterborne diseases, and if we look into the fact of sanitation, we will find that the facility of sanitation in India is very less than even the supply of water. In the 2001 census, it was found that 68% of people have access to drinking water, but only 36% of people have access to sanitation facilities. So this shows how poor the sanitation facility is in India. Now, the sanitation facility is very less in both rural areas and in urban areas. And the people living in both rural and urban areas lack access to proper sanitation facilities. So to solve this problem, a non-government organization called SULAB has come forward. They are working for last few decades to provide sanitation facilities to the people. So especially the lower caste people and the people with low income group, they are not provided proper sanitation facilities. So this SULAB has come forward to provide sanitation facilities to these low caste and low income group people. And this SULAB group has already built almost more than 7,500 public toilets in public toilets and 1.2 million private toilets till now. And this gives access to sanitation facility to more than 10 million people in India. And majority of the users of this public toilets or the sanitation facility is from the poor working class. Now the SULAB enters into contract with municipalities and other local authorities, because it is the responsibility of the municipality to provide sanitation. So the municipality entered into contract with SULAB, and since SULAB is a non-governmental organization, so they don't take much profit, and they construct toilets in low cost. So the municipalities and the local authorities enter into contract with SULAB and to construct the toilet blocks and with the help of government funds. So the government will provide them the money and the SULAB organization will build toilets for them. The local authorities also provide land and funds for setting up of services, whereas maintenance costs are sometimes financed through user charges. Now, building the toilet is not enough. It requires regular cleaning. So, in railway stations and bus stops, public bus stops, you might have seen that there is pay and use toilets. So, where by paying rupees 1 or 2, the maintenance of the toilet can be done, or the cleaning of the toilets can be done with the money which they are taking as user charges. So SULAB constructs latrines or toilets for people, and it's maintained by the people's money in many places. So this is one of the facility which the government has provided through SULAB. So children, in this chapter basically we have studied about all the public facilities like supply of water, sanitation, condition of education, health and transportation in India. So overall we can come to the conclusion that it's the responsibility of the government to provide public facilities, and to a certain extent the government is successful, but if there is any lag in providing public facilities, the government is trying to improve it.